Magnetism for Dummies. Act 1. Magnesia is a region of Greece. It gave its name to a mineral discovered there in antiquity, and the word magnetism was derived from it. The Chinese knew at the same time this stone, which has the property of attracting iron. Before using it much later as a compass, the Chinese used it as an instrument of omen, like the geese of the capital in Rome. The Greek philosophers, Thales in particular, gave it a motor nature that could animate iron. Magnets and iron therefore had an anima, a soul in English, like the stars and all beings affected by motion. The word soul has changed its meaning. The soul of Christians no longer has anything to do with the motion of bodies. The first proven use of the compass for navigation in China would only date back to the 12th century. It can be assumed that trade put Westerners on the path of this discovery in the 13th century. Act 2. Before 1600, William Gilbert maintained that the Earth is a huge magnet, which explains how compasses work. He specified in a qualitative way the rules of attraction and repulsion of magnets, as well as the effect of heat. Unlike gravitation, light and electricity, philosophers and scholars were content to describe the phenomena they observed without trying to explain magnetism. Descartes was the first and indeed the only one to venture to do so. He proposed an explanation of magnetism by the corpuscles of its famous whirling medium filling space. These corpuscles would be fluted in a helix, but half in one direction and half in the other direction, thus forming two kinds of fluids. The Earth would be crossed by small conduits also of two kinds. The north-south can only let pass the helices of one direction, and the south-north, the other helices. These conduits would exist in iron and therefore in magnets from which iron could be extracted. But the forging of iron deforms the conduits so that the corpuscles cannot always circulate in the iron. The two kinds of fluids each circulate in their own conduits. The repulsions and attractions between two magnets would result from the pressure resulting from the two currents of these media. The currents of these fluids in the Earth's conduits return them to the other pole by turning around the Earth. Their effect on the magnetic bars explains their orientation. This model, inspired by fluid mechanics, leaves in the dark the motor, the pumps, behind these fluid flows. Later on, Euler only repeated Descartes' explanation with conduits in the magnets through which two media present in space circulate. Act 3. Was it Newton's interest in the occult sciences, alchemy in particular, which was at the origin of the writings on animal magnetism? The 18th century magnetizers, in particular Franz Anton Mesmer, were the initiators of this animal magnetism, of which the dowsers remain the last followers. The great progressive movement, based on the positivist vision, was from then on going to impose its convictions. It would be strictly without interest or utility to propose physical models. The only thing that matters is to find the mathematical formulation of the phenomena of nature. Newton's law clearly showed the way. Charles Augustine Coulomb invented the torsion balance in 1785. He was able to determine the laws of attraction and repulsion of magnets, as he did for electrical charges. Mathematics is entering magnetism. And this is just a shy start. Act 4. In 1802, Gian Domenico Romagnosi discovered that the current produced by a volt battery turns a magnetic needle. This experiment was rejected by the Paris Academy of Sciences. Romagnosi's experience was taken up in 1820 by Aristide, and his name remained. Ampere noticed around 1830 that an electrical wire through which a current flows attracts another electric wire through which a current flows in the same direction and repels it otherwise. The electric wire therefore behaves like a magnet. Magnetism is therefore a phenomenon common to magnets and electric currents. Maxwell will mathematize what was then called electromagnetism. He attributed the magnetic fields to the electric current in the conductors. This is the famous Maxwell-Ampere equation. This equation was generalized by Maxwell to all space, even without current. You cancel the current J and you obtain the Maxwell-Hertz equation of electromagnetic waves. It's a scientifically inconceivable sleight of hand. The current in a conductor results from the electric field in this conductor. And this field comes from the extraction of electrons at one end of the conductor, which therefore draws as many, so to speak, at its other end. The extraction of electrons is produced by the electric battery or the generator. The field results from this kind of depression of the cloud of electrons in the conductor. If this depression is removed, the electric current is removed obviously, but the electric field is also removed. It is completely absurd to delete the term relating to the electric current in the Maxwell-Ampere equation and to keep the term relating to electric field. The two are indissolubly linked. This is why scientists now claim that the Maxwell-Hertz equation is a pure postulate which in no way results from the Ampere equation despite Maxwell's intention. Act 5. At the same time the theory of atoms was being developed. Electrons circulating on stable orbits would not emit electromagnetic radiation. The tragedy is that this Bohr hypothesis already contains the hidden assumption that the speed of electrons is not the cause of magnetic fields, in complete contradiction with Maxwell's theory. However, several phenomena then came to confirm this fundamental fact that the speed of electrons is not the cause of magnetic fields. Quantum mechanics attributes the magnetic properties of all materials to the intrinsic magnetic field of electrons, except for conductors. It's still weird. In cyclotrons, an electron beam has no magnetic field at the exit, although they travel at speeds of several tens of thousands of kilometers per second. So the magnetic field cannot result from the speed of the electrons. In the 1950s, the dream was to produce electricity without an alternator by making an ionized fluid flow at high speed in a circular circuit, the magnetohydrodynamics. It is the equivalent of a loop crossed by a current. However, this loop has no magnetic field. So the speed of electrons plays no part in magnetic fields. Quantum mechanics was led to assume that the electron would be a negative charge of zero dimension. The question now is how could the rotation of a dimensionless charge produce a magnetic field? The magnetic field of the electron is therefore necessarily a property belonging to the electron on its own, a property which does not depend in any way on its speed. Intrinsic magnetic field or speed of electrons? Two causes for the same magnetic phenomenon. I don't know if the expression who can least applies in physics. The principle of simplicity, the famous Occam razor states the opposite. For relativists these problems cannot exist. These are misinterpreted facts. Like Marxists, relativists recognize good facts that confirm their theory and reject bad facts, which are subjective idealism. Sweeping all the questions, defying all the paradoxes, ignoring all the inconsistencies, the relativists claim without waiting to bring back the electromagnetic forces and all the forces of nature, in a single law, mathematical of course, the outcome of the positivist project of our progressives. The end of science? Not at all. The end of the mathematized positivism of the progressives. Thank you.